Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. In this particular video today, guys, I'm going to show you how to bring back focus in a soft focus photo. But before we dive into this video, come on, take a minute, subscribe to this channel. Come on, hit that subscribe button. Of course, give this video a thumbs up if you love it. I would love to know at the end of this tutorial what has really resonated with you and how better are you getting into your photography. Let's dive into this already. I'm going to show you how to bring back details, how to bring back sharpness in an image whose focus is not as crisp as it is supposed to be. Now, when you look at this image, it has a focus in the forehead, but when you look at the eyes, it has that kind of haze and soft focus. And that is what we want to. We want the eyes to be as crisp as the forehead here. And we also want this part of the cheeks to be as crisp as this particular forehead. So what do we do? You know, there are incidences where you take pictures and for some reason, maybe a model moves or you move a particular distance and the focus doesn't really grip the image so well as you want, like in this incidence here. So let me show you how to bring back focus in this particular image. So what do we do? You come here, duplicate this layer twice, just like this, by dragging it down here. And then you come and unsee this. We're going to come and call this, unsee this. And you come, we are going to use a blur technique. Yes, it's very odd that we are again going to use blur to bring back focus. So how do we do this? You come here, click onto this, come here into filter, say blur, and then you say Gaussian blur. But this is where the magic is. The real magic is in how much you blur out here. So all these textures, we're going to make a very slight blur and see all the textures we want to bring back have to be blurred here. So how do we do that? You just come here like that and we blur all these textures just out like that. You take it slow because you don't want to take it overboard. You just want only that ulterior texture to be back. So you just come and blur it out just a little bit. I mean, it doesn't have to be a lot. That is enough for me. You don't have even to take it overboard. So you come here and say, okay. So the next thing we are going to do, let us wait for it to the effect to take effect. You come and, of course, make this visible again. You select the upper layer, this one here, and then you come into image. You say apply image, and then you come into this particular source. You select, the layer, this particular layer panel. You come here and select the background copy. You make sure it's the one that is showing right there. So you put this into subtract. You put the scale at 2. You put the offset at 128. And then you say, okay. So the next thing you're going to do here, let us wait for the action to take place. You come here and say linear light, just like that. Okay, now this is where the magic is. So we're just going to come here and just remove this. You see how the focus, the sharpness comes back? Now look at this. That is the before. Look at the after. The before and after. See how we bring back details into, look at that. This is the before and this is the after. Before and after. So basically this is the whole technique. So if, what if I don't want this to be again overly sharp and we want only the sharpness to be in this particular zone, what do? I just come and create a layer mask just next to this particular layer. I'll call this sharpness. Yes, just so that we follow along. I come into the sharpness layer and then select the layer mask, make sure it's selected, and then I press Ctrl I to invert the mask. Then I'll get my brush tool here and then just make sure it's white that is on top, because remember, black hides and white reveals. So you just come and paint over here, of course, with the opacity and flow in 100. So I just come and paint over and bring back all these details. I also come in the eye and make the eyes even sharper, all these details around here. See how we are bringing back the focus to the whole image? I mean, It is that simple. Basically, sharpening is about creating contrast all around every single pixel. So the more you blur it out, the wider your contrast will be. But the less you blur it out, the smaller the contrast will be around those a particular pixel. That is how sharpness basically works, you know. And I just come and sharpen all these particular, see how we bring back all these details also here above the eye, above that, because we don't want it all over the whole image. And then maybe in the neck area, like that. So let me just put this in a group and I show you the before and after. Look at this. Okay, I just want you guys to see. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. Let me zoom it in. I don't know whether you guys are seeing the difference. A big, big difference. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. That's the before, that's the after. See how the pores all come back and get on top? Yes, even if you want to make it even more, you can just come and duplicate this layer again. You just come and duplicate this so that the sharpness becomes more. But this is too much for my taste, so I'll just come and delete it over here. Yes, guys, that's how you bring back focus into an image that is out of focus using Photoshop. I'll see you in my next tutorial. That's that for today. And remember to kill the subscribe button, of course, also kill the like button. And in the comments below, tell me what has really resonated with you in this particular tutorial. And adios.